Around 4 months ago, when we were first assigned this project, we formed our groups but couldn't think of any topics to work on. I asked my parents for suggestions, and my father mentioned about the Sidik tribe, an indigenous Taiwanese tribe who fought against the Japanese colonization. I've never heard of this tribe before, despite the fact that I am a Taiwanese person myself. My curiosity towards this tribe grew. Our group booked a plane ticket to Taiwan straight away to learn more about the Sidik tribe. The Sidik people inhabited in the mountains of Wuxi. Their life was self-supplied, and they were isolated from the outside world. Each tribe had their own unique traits, and the facial tattoos are Sidik people's trait, symbolizing maturity and bravery. Despite the fact that the indigenous tribes had a culture of cutting each other tribesmen's head for good luck, Sidik tribe maintained a good relationship with other tribes. After all, the Sidik tribe lived peacefully in the mountains without government control, until the Japanese invasion in 1895. We knew that the Sidik tribe made the first successful revolt against the Japanese, called the Wuxi Incident, but weren't quite sure about the details. We went to Nantou, Wuxi to see if we could learn anything about the Wuxi Incident there. However, we were fortunate enough to get Takun Wallace contact, a descendant of the Sidik tribe. The next day, we visited him in the mountains for an interview. He told us that the causes of the Wuxi incident could be divided into three major parts: ban of weapons, Renjiguan incident, and the Jianmeiyuan incident. After the Japanese soldiers settled in the woods where those tribesmen lived, they went around and confiscated weapons from them. This infuriated the tribes because they hunted in the woods for food. But now that they didn't have any weapons, they started to starve. In 1903, the Japanese government banned the domestic trade market Taiwanese indigenous tribes used for survival. This event was called the Renjiguan. It took half a year before the indigenous tribes started to run out of food. After the tribespeople's incessant complaints, the Japanese government set out a new trade market. However, this market turned out to be a fraud, getting everyone drunk and killing anyone who came for trade. This event was called the Jianmeiyuan Incident. And after the people back in their tribe heard this news, they were enraged. The Sidik people who were kept under control by the Japanese system of ruling, called the Yifan Zhifan, were the potential threats to the Japanese were killed, making a revolt against the Japanese government nearly impossible. The Japanese armies killed anyone who was a potential threat to them, disabling the tribespeople from revolting against them. We were also informed from Takun Wallace that there were other minor factors, such as paying tribes to kill each other, which led the tribes to get enraged with the Wuxi incident.
风水以后就不方便，那日本人很聪明，他就设定一个鸿门宴了，他是布农族旁边，我们布农族本来跟富江拿人头，日本临时做一个市集，就是市场，其实那个是骗局，那我们的人听说哎呀会换东西啊，那就我们人多去嘛，来个一下子来个一百人，一百多人去，一到万隆去，日本已经召集了布农族的勇士，这个两三百人在附近，那日本在那在五界。 前面一个在前面也事件的，前面那边设一个圈套，我们的人一百多人去那边都带枪带什么都去，以为是真的是要交换，一直在日本九点开始请我们喝酒，听说是从早上九点到下午三点，差不多以后那个醉了，日本就一声号令就把到周围的两三百个那个布农族杀我们，简直就杀西瓜一样砍头啊！
就醉了嘛，啊，有的有的是没有，有的是就跳上去，有的逃回来，大概一百人，一百多人，剩下五六个人出来而已。In 1930, Mono Rudolph, who no longer could endure the Japanese treatments towards them, decided to convince other tribe leaders to join him in the revolt against the Japanese. 6 out of the 12 tribes agreed, and they came to a conclusion that they would strike the Japanese on the following sports day, which was held in a small village called Wuxi, when everyone in town attended. They broke into an unguarded weapon storage, where the Japanese kept all their weapons and ones confiscated from the tribes, and killed every Japanese people, including women and children. This event was broadcast in Japan, and the Sidik people were called barbarians who betrayed Japan that were trying to civilize them.
就运动会的时候，日本才会集中。
啊，对对对，那小
就是、
那个、学校的
日本人他不晓得，他以为原住民，他以为我们原住民人，我们常年野兽我们都可以抓啦、啊。那你这个人没有比野兽聪明啊？他们就讲好要派要运动会那天，先把各部落的警察杀掉，把电线全部切掉，然后我们到分局那边去抢他们的那个武器，
拿那些。
其实雾社事件当天在现场的时候。几乎全乡的所有各族群都杀了，大概这雾社事件就大概就主要原因，一个是民怨太深了。
A few months after the Wuxi incident, the Japanese government sent army troops to Wuxi and killed everyone who was involved with this incident. Due to this, the word Wuxi incident was considered a forbidden word among the Taiwanese tribes. Takan Wallace told us that he wasn't even aware of the incident until he was in college.For further effects of the Wuxi incident, we met Mr. Chen, who specifically studied Taiwanese indigenous tribes in the National Museum of Taiwan. He told us that the Sidic tribe's action represented a clash between barbarism and civilization. It gave other groups of people that were dominant by other superior groups hope because the Wuxi incident proved that they have a chance against the civilized ones. Despite the fact that the Sidic tribe was not ruled by the Taiwanese government,They were honored as patriots after the Republic of Taiwan developed. The Taiwanese government used Wuxi incident to cause a propaganda in Taiwan to fight against Japanese rules that remained in Taiwan. In the meantime, the story of Wuxi incident was told in France as well, where it promoted the factory workers to revolt against their owners.
雾社事件在这个角色上面其实一直都是很正向的。我们很清楚的看到是国民政府想要利用雾社事件来去对抗日本这件事情、哦、就是日本都是坏的。雾社事件在台湾不是一个负面的形象，一直都是正面的形象，只是那个正面的形象不一定是从原住民的角度来看，为了要对抗日本这个军国主义、哦，可是那个跟当时原住民真正要反抗的那个概念是没有关系的，它不是针对日本，而只要是一个暴力的一个殖民者，他们其实都会反抗。
The Sidic tribe took a stand against the Japanese rules when the other tribes all remained silent, despite the fact that they were mistreated. While all the other tribes were just watching their own culture being destroyed by the new Japanese education system and new Japanese law.The Sidic tribe decided to take a stand and successfully revolted against them. Some might say that they weren't influential, since the Japanese defeated them in the end, but we disagree. The Sidic tribe's bravery and love towards their people were noticed all around the globe, and their stories are now currently included in Taiwanese textbooks. Without their effort, their culture and traditions would have been wiped completely out of history. After all, history cannot be changed, but history can be forgiven.Lemosu